Do you know where the Chinese restaurant is in the High Street?
Yes.
In West Street?
Yes, yes.
Well, I was born up there.
Yeah?
I was born there.
In there?
97 years ago. When my father was manager for Singer Sewing Machine.
My word. Have you always lived in Sittingbourne then?
Yeah.
Yeah. Not far from here?
No.
Where do you live now?
Market Court in Frederick Street.
Oh, yeah.
What a Camden. I used to be a warden at Market Court at Junction House in Burley Road.
Oh, yes, yeah. Yeah.
And I come from there. They turfed us out of our flats, us old people, and put in our married mothers.
Oh.
Yeah. And still our married mothers turfed us all out. We had to go where we were put. So another thing or two, you know.
We've been doing some sewing. And it's just very interesting because everybody in the group can see different parts or different things and different colours.
Oh, lovely.
Which bits can you see?
Pretty.
Can you see the orange?
Yes,
it stands out quite well, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And the texture's nice, isn't it?
I can't even say it, but not now.
Can you see this white up here?
Yes, it's lacy, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Like almost like big crochet.
Okay, I was going to say that's crochet, isn't it?
Yeah, but with quite a stiff thread.
Yes.
Not very giving.
Oh, really nice.
And can you see these down here? These
sequins. Aren't they pretty?
So they've got quite a prickly texture.
Oh, aren't they pretty? It's a runner, isn't it?
It is like a runner, yes.
Like a runner for a sideboard.
Yeah.
I wish I'd got somewhere to put it. I'd have it. I will. This.
Say that again.
Not only sewing machines, but by hand. And then you come to a dead stop like I am. It makes you wonder why you stopped. Because your brain won't work against your hands, will they?
No.
And they won't work together.
No.
Not as you get older.
Yes. Obviously, when you can't see, it's
I can't
quite...
see. I can see that. It's
yes.
Cold. What is it? Does it say something?
No, but you're right. It could say something. It has that kind of
it's
quality
feeling,
to it.
Yes. It feels like words.
So did your sight go gradually?
It is going gradually.
Yes.
I mean, last week I could write my name and see figures and add them up. I can't do that this week.
Oh, so that's quite a big change within a week.
Yeah, it's terrible.
Yes.
And I could sort my money out, but I can't do it this week. I couldn't do it. It started last week.
Yeah.
And Marty had to do it for me.
Yes, yeah. And then it's quite subtle, I suppose. You realise the things that you can't do.
I do.
Mm.
Is it when you get tired?
No, I don't. I'll tell you the honest truth. I don't get tired.
My
name was?
Did you have relatives down Tong Lane?
Not to my name,
no, that was Bridges, wasn't it?
Bridges, I was going to say that.
That's
Bridges,
right.
Weren't they?
That's right. No, I was getting a bit confused there.
Wrist Bridges.
You hold that bit for me like that, and I'll twist round this bit here at the end. So you're the last of the lasts?
I am.
Yes, I got your pun, yes.
I still do my own washing. I still do my shopping when I feel like it.
Down Sittingbourne High Street?
Yeah, with a trolley. But I have to have somebody with me.
Yeah.
What are you making this? I'm going round and round.
Well, I thought, on the piece that you tried on this morning for us, I might help with Joan's help, construct some kind of big collar. So what I'm trying to do, Patsy, is always think about how different people maybe we can't all do the same thing, but we can all have a go at different things. Yes. So thinking on my feet, this is what Joan and I are doing now. But it feels nice, doesn't it, Joan?
Yes, it feels lovely, cuddly.
It does cuddly. Yes, it is cuddly. Yeah. Yes, I think that one will do, actually. Shall we make another one? So, there you go, Patsy. Come and have a look. I'll pass it over. It's like a big soft cauliflower.
Oh, I see.
Let's.
And what material is this?
I might try and join them together.
I know. What material is this?
Well, this is the bamboo. Let me read the instruction to you.
Yes.
It says, it's fascinating this, bamboo cotton batting, B-A-T-T-I-N-G, it's a special craft product, and it's made with long staple cotton and softest bamboo fibre. No chemicals and no bleaching, eco-friendly material.
Lovely and soft, isn't it?
It is beautifully soft. Mm. I think it's used a lot for quilting and padding and filler, so that would be for quilting.
Yes, you could use it as a backing.
Yes, but I saw it in the shop and it reminded me of the blankets and just so lovely. I just thought it was so lovely. So let's make another one, shall we?
I don't know who did that.
Hurry up, otherwise I should be too late.
Don't rush, Patsy. So that's the worst thing you can do, isn't it? Mind your fingers, Joan. That's it. Right, I'll get another bit of wadding.
Myself on bits of wood and doors and going. I keep coming up in brushes.
Bruce, Joan. Oh dear. Is it because you're just banging into things?
No. I've got a table under my window and I'm all shushing in with my knees.
Right, so pull that one up, Joan. Pull that one up.
Oh, they don't have that, you're cross when you get old, don't
they? Frustration. Are you in close enough now?
You're all right.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're in charge of holding the top knot. That's it. It's a tough one, Joe. It's a tough one. Right, hang on a minute.
What is that all in there? That cotton wool is that?
Yeah, it's like wadding. Yes.
Yeah.
That's it. Are you going on the holiday, Joe?
No, I've been on so many lovely holidays with them. I can't stick it now.
You're going, aren't you, Rose?
Yes.
Yes. Right, if you hold that like that, I'll do the end. That's it. I'll just lie him down and put a little knot in there. Talking about it as if it's a baby.
Yeah. It's funny how they some soft toys fascinate people.
They do, don't they?
I don't know, my daughter.
Yeah.
She's in the cake making.
Oh, that's a booming industry at the moment, isn't it? Yeah? Brilliant, that's another one. Shall we wait one more?
It's up to you.
Not tiring you out?
No. He's going to help you, I'll help you.
Does she do the decorated cakes?
Wow.
Does your daughter do the decorated cakes?
Yes, she does. You'd be surprised some of the things. She had somebody come the other day who wanted a motorbike.
Yeah.
A boy, 18.
She had to do football pitches more than once.
Cricket grounds. She's done a five tiers high wedding cake, which has been very busy over Easter.
I'd love to try, yes, I really would, and then you could take that home, couldn't you?
Yeah.
So if I get you a needle and thread,
you're going to trust me with this then, Nicola,
of course. Any particular colour
for this?
Yes. If I show you the range, I'll be with you in a minute, Joan.
Oh, are they?
I should think of. Bright yellow would be the best colour to suit them for me because of the, you know, brightness against the. Am I going to try blanket stitch?
You're good.
Anything you like. Anything you like. I should have to bring all my needles for you to thread before I take things home, then I can carry on.
Ready and waiting. That's not bad. It's not a silly idea as it sounds,
is it? That really is a handicap.
I could do that for you. I could give you a selection of needles.
Really?
Yes, if it means.
Gosh, it means carrying the difference between
you sitting there and thinking, right, I've got a week, I've got all these needles threaded, I can do this.
Oh, that'd be wonderful.
Yeah, wonderful. Absolutely.
Oh, thank you so much.
No.
Right, Jo,
I'm going to try.
Back now.
It's a bit like
Anne reading the pattern to Rose, isn't it? It's whatever system works.
Yeah.
So if having a load of needles threaded up...
I don't know whether this needle will go through this.
I'll come and have a look.
It's fairly tough.
You don't value what is easy, you take it for granted, that's right.
It's only when it isn't there that you realise just how lucky it is.
I don't ask my daughter to do much for me. I'm going to do it.
My daughter takes me shopping once a week.
Yeah.
Do a big shop, but the rest of the time I'm coping by myself.
But I've got a very good lady in my place in Mamokiko, Kathy. She's a North Country girl and she's very, 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 very good to me.
She's patient, is she?
Yes, she takes me shopping and we go down the aisles and she says, do you want anything here? So-and-so. No. Who are you off for so-and-so? She would do my shopping for me.
Oh, very nice too.
Yeah. She's 10 years younger than I am, though.
She's 10 years
younger than I am. I mean, when I was her age...
So she's my age, 80?
87.
Oh, I'm 88.
Yeah. She'll be 88. Oh, no, 87 next week. That's all right. Oh, she's an angel, honest.
Can you hold that bit for me, Joan? Thank you.
Can I have the other one?
Yeah, that's it.
And what are we making there?
Well, we're not quite sure at the moment, Joan. I've got an idea. I might have to go away and think about it a bit more. Mm. And then I'll let you know in 2 weeks' time. It'll give me something to do, won't it, Joan?
Okay. Well, washing up or
keep her out of mischief until
keep
next
me busy.
Week.
Yes, yes. You watch, I'll come back and I'll say, Joan, actually, I've decided we've got to make 50. Are you up for it? Thank you.
I just now have something to do.
That's the idea. That's what we've been talking about. Did you used to do embroidery, Joan?
Well, not to that extent. My sister Maud was the one for that.
Yeah.
There we are, ma'am.
Rosie, thank you very much.
Made her a skirt?
No, it's another cape, a full-length cape that trails all around her.
Full-length cape, just like Patsy had on today. Brilliant. Thank you, Joan. We've done that.
I think
you're right. There's a bigger one. One more, just before we close.
We've got time.
I think we've got probably got
enough time, probably, if you fancy. If you need a rest, I totally understand. Because you haven't stopped working all day. Have a look. Let me show you and then you can decide, yes?
Oh, it's interesting to see what you're all doing down here.
Could you thread some stuff through that? There's plenty here.
Now, how can we make that interesting?
Last challenge. They're quite thick. You could put quite a few through there, actually. Shall I leave you to think? Well, I've got a thicker piece if you wanted a really thick piece.
Well, no, I was thinking of the contrast between that and that.
Is nice.
But one down the middle to cover up the join.
Yes.
Let's try that one.
It might be a bit thick, but I've got
It's too much like the background, isn't it?
Oh, it is a bit like that. Hang on a minute. Hang on.
Are you in the creative mood then, Rose? Sounds like it.
Any good?
Trying to get the green in, but I'm not going to get two bits in, am I?
I'm having a little thing. Oh, I found another one, actually.
Was you getting tired here?
Say that again.
Was you getting tired here?
Me?
Oh, what did I do? Make a mistake? Oh, yes, no, you're right. I was, actually.
I did.
What did she do then,
Rose? I was a bit slack.
Look.
Yeah. Oh, I can't really see.
Not very level.
No, I can't really see. No. Do you know, I did it at work, and I think I was talking to students at the same time. Which, of course, one shouldn't do. There's a bit... Oh, you... No.
That's about my best.
Yeah. Okay, dear.
Okay.
We'll cope.
Lovely. Joan, should we just make one more? Then we'll have done 4 out of 50, won't we?
Wow, you are.
Productive.
Are you getting permission?
For making odd things.
What is this stuff, Joan?
Well, this is actually stuff from inside a pillowcase.
Oh.
I think quite a cheap pillowcase.
Yeah.
But,
You know when you... That's not the memory foam stuff.
No, this is cheap pillowcase. You know when they go, you know you've got a cheap pillowcase because it goes bobbly, lumpy quite quickly. Yeah, and it's from a cheap, I mean, it's ideal if you're going camping or something, you've got a cheap pillowcase, but they are very frustrating because they go, it's almost like overnight, they go lumpy, don't they?
And then you can't plump them up at all.
No, can't do anything with them at all. How long have you been coming to the club then, Joan?
Well, I'm the oldest and the longest member.
Oh, my word.
Quite something, isn't it?
That is, yes.
Yeah.
You hold that
95.
Really?
Yeah.
So 20-odd years?
Yeah. Well, I've been here 29 years.
Who was running it then? Joan?
Pardon?
Who was running it then?
Anne's been here for donkeys.
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Doreen hasn't been here quite so long.
Yeah, no. Doreen came just before we left the Wesleyan.
Oh, I didn't realise Anne had been that long.
Yes, she told me that when I first met her.
Yeah, I know. Anne was doing it.
Every Tuesday?
Every Tuesday, yeah.
Unbelievable.
I've been living at Mocket Court 29 years. I was the first person in there.
And did you have a choice of where you could live then, Joan?
Pardon?
Or did they tell you where you got to live, or could you choose in Moffat's Court?
Yeah. I was the first one in there. Yeah, I could have had number 1 or number 92.
Which one did you pick then?
Number 16. It's right along the end of the corridor.
Yeah.
And nobody can get in or get out.
You're sensible, see?
Yeah.
And if I see them go by my kitchen window, I'm right there like a thought shot and say, where the hell do you think you're going? And they turn around and walk away.
He's going to bed.
Oh, Rose.
He's got his toothpaste, look.
Yes.
His brush.
Yes.
His water bottle he's got.
Yes.
And his girlfriend.
Oh, Rose.
Rose knitted them.
I knitted them back in the 70s.
You did that?
Yes. Mm. My mum used to read the patterns. Well, it's all stocking stitch. The only bit my mum helped with and a friend was a little bit round the top of his, the little pointed bits on the top of his hat.
On his top of his hat?
And on, round his round her knickers.
Yeah. Yeah.
Round the bottom of her knickers.
Let me have a little,
little pointy bits, isn't it? That's all they did, that first row, and the rest I did myself. Well, it's only stocking stitch, isn't it?
Rose, this is the jumper. This is your jumper. You knitted.
Yes.
I've asked her to put it on today.
Yes.
Because we're going to take some photos, because we've been chosen as a charity for the forum. And Marco's going to take some photos of her later, so we can put a photo up, because we've got a board. We need to advertise the club, what we do at the club, to get more members.
Yes. Take one of the dollies.
Yeah.
That's the only bit I couldn't do, them little new people.
Oh, well, appreciate
sit down, darling, and I'll leave you talking to Nicola. Is that all
right? Okay, yes.
Fine. That's, and at the bottom of her dress also has got the...
peaky bits.
But you've done that in a different colour as well. That's amazing. Do you know what the thing is, Rose? I can't see one dropped stitch.
I don't drop stitches.
No, you just don't, do you?
I just don't. I see my mum did her face.
Yes. Did she sew those in?
She embroidered, like, with her... Yeah, she might, like, done her knitting. Never knitted them. She just picked those darning needles.
The needles, yeah. And he's got knitted eyebrows.
Yes.
The fella?
Yes.
Yeah. And a knitted nose. That's unbelievable. Honestly, Rose, that's fantastic.
And the little, they're only strips of plain knitting, look.
Yes.
Stocking stitch. And
very effective, though. Really good. Really good. And the toothbrush is lovely.
Yeah.
Has it got a bit of cardboard inside it? It's up here.
Yeah,
Rose.
Yeah.
It's up here.
Yeah, a little bit of cardboard. A toothbrush, even in the, I think it's his feet.
Yes.
Yeah, they're in the bottom of his boots.
Oh,
got
yes.
Cardboard toes in his boots.
That's very good. That is really good. And bows on his shoes. I love that. And I love his little clock. It says 10:30. And his hot water bottle with a little patch on it.
Yeah, and the little...
Yep.
Squeezed too much toothpaste out, didn't he?
Well, he did, but that, it comes out really easily, doesn't it?
Yeah,
it does do that. It does. And the little writing on there, it says Denter.
Denton, yeah.
Yeah, for his teeth. You're really proud of them. They're really good.
My mum did the tying bits of faces.
Yeah, yeah.
My mum was very good at knitting.
Was she? Well,
oh, my mum
got it from your mum then, yeah.
Yeah, and aunties.
Yeah.
My mum used to knit skirts for us in panels wide and got narrow on
lovely.
A pen. And then, because she couldn't hold them up being little, she'll know it.
Yeah.
Little straps went over and they crossed at the back.
Oh, like a brace, yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Little straps over, cross over at the back. But the button's only at the front. So when you put your skirt on, you just pull the straps on and button them on.
Yeah.
And then she'd knit them and then you'd have little skirt in navy blue with a red jumper on.
Oh, lovely. Lovely. The jumper you've got on, though, is really nice.
You like it?
I love the grey and the red together.
Oh, yeah. Friend Rob.
Yeah.
He buys me lots of wool.
Yeah, it's good wool. Yeah.
And he come in and he said, I bought this wool for a jumper.
Yeah.
And I said, oh, it's what I said. It takes 4 balls to wool to knit me a jumper. Oh, I've only bought you 2 red and 2 gold. I said, all right.
Yeah. Right, that's okay.
And that's what I did.
Well, I love it.
Look
what you've done.
It's only the.
I like the length of sleeve as well, actually. Because
yeah, but when you got when I got long sleeves, I'm pushing them out.
Yeah, for washing.
Now indoors, I've got a blue one, and the blue's a bit longer to there.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's got a lower neck.
Yeah.
And that's 2 shades of blue.
Oh.
I didn't fetch that one. I thought I'd wear one.
Yeah.
I should have bought the blue one with me, shouldn't I?
Oh, I can see it.
Yeah.
Do you want to do some sewing now? Now you're here.
Well, nothing to do.
Are you busy now?
I've only got my black knitting to do. Me.
Do you want to do some of my sewing?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Right. This lady and gentleman, I shall sit on a chair of their own, okay, over here, and I'll get some sewing out, okay? I'll put them over here carefully.
I think you better tell. Oh, well, they know where I am, won't they?
I don't think, you can't go far in here, can you? Can't get lost.
Can't get lost.
Not with me. You can't get lost when you're with me, yeah? Let me get
I thought you'd like, because. I said to my friend, I'm telling him about you. So he said, I said, oh, yeah, interested. He said, and I said, I made the laugh, but I said, oh, I make everybody laugh with you. I can't see black knitting.
Oh, well, that was a good story, though.
Yeah, he does laugh.
He does.
And he said, yeah, what about your babies upstairs? And I said, what babies?
Oh.
He went out and he chucked him in my house. He said, Willy Willy Winking, your little Victorian dolly. He said, I bet that lady would be pleased to see that if she's done.
Oh, was. Well, I walked in. I walked in, and the first thing I saw was them on the table in their plastic bag. But it's a clear plastic bag.
Oh, you could see.
And I could see, and I thought, Rose has brought something in to show me.
Yes, I thought you'd be interested.
I'm going to thread you up a needle.
Haven't you got self-threaded ones?
Well, I haven't, no, but...
You have to get them to get some.
I have to get them to get
some. Yeah, and then there's some little things like a little tin plate with a little bit of fuse wire. And I'm good at that. I can push it through the hole.
Oh, yes, push it through the hole, yeah.
Oh, come on.
I'm coming.
You've got to get things for blind people.
I know. I'm a complete novice, aren't I?
No, not really. No. When you teach other people.
I know.
I bet you say, I've got a blind lady and she's clever. You'll do that when they say, they can't do it, miss.
Do you know what, though, Rose? I did go home and I sat there sort of in stunned silence and said to my husband and my sons, I said, actually, I can't believe what these people, and I did mention your name, I said, I can't believe what they do in a day. And So I had a little practice. In the kitchen, I washed up with my eyes closed. And then my husband and I went for a little walk, and I held onto his hand. And in the end, he had to stop saying, he had to say in the end, he had to say, will you stop doing the practicing? I said, but it just amazes me. Absolutely amazes me.
Well, but if you go on your own with a white cane.
Exactly. Well, then, see, I didn't do that, did I? Because I just, well.
No, but you can't.
Morning.
Good morning. You can't have a white cane, can you? So that's it.
No. But
see, well, I've just retired. They've retired my guide dog in November.
Oh, really?
So I've had a guide dog, four guide dogs, so 40 years.
Really?
So I was quite an independent lady. Oh, God, I was
What kind of dog was it?
First one was a curly coat retriever.
Yeah.
Then I had a smooth coat Labrador retriever. She was golden cream, Hazel.
Mm-hmm.
Then I had Dancer. She was white and beige. Then I had Sarah that's gold colour, dark goldy brown.
Yeah.
And she's indoors now.
Oh, is
she? They just retired the last November.
So, do you get another one?
No, not having no more.
No more?
Okay.
Shall I give you this needle?
No, they said no, they're not going to give me a dog, so.
Okay. So, now, what I would like, this is a blanket, yes?
Yeah.
It's just for you to just enjoy doing some stitching. Just enjoy doing the stitching.
What do you want me? Hem it along or just stitch a blanket stitch or rally stitch?
Would you like to do a blanket stitch then?
Yeah. I've just got on your makeup.
Yeah, go on then. That's lovely, thank you. That's great.
He's come out.
It's all right. No, he's all right.
Oh, it's all right.
Yeah.
I didn't get it through.
Do you miss the dog?
Yes. I can't go out, can I? On my own.
Yeah.
I'm stuck indoors.
I bet the
running out of shopping. It's getting a nightmare, it like, really is.
Is it? Is there someone to help?
Not really. They're all lovely friends. Oh, yeah, we'll do it. But my friend is right over Chatham. He loaded me up when he came last week. Yeah, but it's not the same, is it?
No.
Somebody coming to fetch stuff. You like to go buy your own stuff, don't you?
Well, you do really, because it's part of the independence, but it's quite fun to do that as well, isn't it?
Well, you can choose the bacon and cheese you like.
Yes.
They look, oh, that'd be nice, but it's not the bacon I'd have.
Yes. Does someone help you in the shop then?
If you go on your own, yes.
Yeah. You've got a knot in there already.
Big.
A big knot, I know. Let's see if I can get them out. Maybe I made that too long. I'm learning, Rose, I'm learning. I think we're learning all the time, aren't we?
So what do you tell your husband then?
Wow, what did I tell him?
What?
I told him... I was a bit speechless, to be honest.
Oh, we're number four, are we?
We're number four, are we? I don't know what that means. What's number four?
Well, I don't know, you've got it on the back of your shirt. So.
Oh, I'm number four, yeah, of course I'm number four. I've got a t-shirt on.
You've been in a running race?
Like it looks like I've been in a running race. There's no way I've been in a running race. And of course he's noticed that I'm number four on the back.
Right, now what I'm going to be in the process of doing...
Yes.
Because we've been elected as charity for the local shopping centre, I'm going to be taking some pictures so we can attach them to a board to show what the club do. Now, I do have to ask everybody that if there's anyone that's got any objections to having their picture taken. I know this one's all right because we've done it before, haven't we, Rose?
Yes. Yeah, we've just got a full makeup.
I mean, what we have to do, we've got to be careful because
yes,
in this day and age, they're so fussy.
Yes, yeah, no, that's fine.
Actually, I had a colleague about 3 years ago.
Yeah.
A person complained to him when he was taking pictures of a wedding because they took pictures of their child.
Oh, yes.
It's a bit crazy, but.
That's lovely what you're doing. Can I take a photograph of you?
I was blind, and my sister said they're getting married.
Yeah.
And my dad said, "Do you have your rose as a bridesmaid?" "Well, I don't know, Dad." He said, "Right. She's a bridesmaid. You don't be a bride. End of story." Always buys me a bag with lots of compartments.
I suppose the compartments are good because then you can put different things in.
Yeah, purse in the middle and
cane on the top.
And then all the other bits, you've got bus pass and all the shop things that you have in the shops. And
that can go down there. Okay, I'll keep an eye on that for you down there.
Oh, it's with me, I know it's there now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, I had some signature, a plastic signature card, and it's gone out my purse, and it's this is the only place I leave it. When I went home last week, it had gone.
Oh, well, what's happened there then?
Well, somebody took out my bag, haven't they?
Oh, Rose.
Well, you can't say anything, can you? Because they say you're accusing someone.
Yeah.
Of course they're blind, don't say they don't pinch things.
Yeah. What have you done this week, Rose?
Me? Not a lot. I haven't been out, so I've done a lot of knitting. I've done two fronts of the cardigan.
Yes.
And I'm on the back at the moment. And I'm halfway up on that, but I've got to do 18 inches before I do the armhole shape, so I think I've done about 10 inches of that.
Another 8 to go.
And then I've got the sleeves to do. And then Anna stitch it up. And you know Maureen out there, I called her the laughing lady.
Yeah, yeah.
It's for her daughter.
Ah.
Yeah, I've got this jumper. I've got a two-tone blue one. And the big... I will listen. See what it's going to say.
Right, now I'm sure... I wasn't here at the moment in time, but I'm sure last week Anne explained to you about us becoming the charity in the forum for the year. Now there's a community day in the forum on Saturday, which they want us to take part in. Now, I'm going to make up a board with a bit about what the club's on, and I also want some photos to go on the board. So I'm asking some of you to take part in these photographs so that they can be displayed in the forum on Saturday. Now, anybody that's got any objections to having their photo taken, right, you're out. Anyone that has any objections, please tell me now. You always get one of them. Is there anybody that
might be chosen as a film star?
Oh,
ooh,
yeah.
Right, that's fine. So you know what it's all about, and basically,
I did a film for Midway Hospital.
Did you?
Basically, it is in your interest because obviously it will bring money into the club.
Yeah.
Which will be for your benefit.
So we're not doing the calendar girls thing. Well,
it was everybody involved, God, to get it.
He's got
you always get somebody.
You can't do it.
Yes.
Go.
Yes.
All right, have a go. If you can't do it, fair enough, but if you sit quietly, you'll do it, and I did.
Well, it's a nice thing to do, isn't it?
My mum used to be a bit, but once she knew I could do it, and much she'd say to my sisters, take her upstairs, take her to the loo. When they got there, they'd say, go on, Rose, quick, go on your own. And they'd rush off and do it and come back. And when we went back, she thought they took me, but they didn't. They were good sisters.
How many sisters have you got, Rose?
Four. Three brothers.
Oh, there were seven of you.
Eight
of you, sorry.
Yeah, but in that lot, there was only 10. Because my mum had a son, twin boys, a daughter, a son, me, Daphne, and then she finished off with twin girls. I had twin brothers and twin sisters.
She was busy. Very busy.
Later on, because Mark was taking some photographs.
Yes.
because we're going to display those, because we've got this charity day on Saturday.
Yes.
But Marge has got a knitting.
Yes.
And she said, you said you'd like to see her doing this knitting.
Yes, yes.
So Michael's going to take a photograph of her doing the knitting.
Yes.
We'll let you know when. But I think she wants to come out here and sit to have it done.
Yeah.
Because she don't want no distractions.
Yes, so, of course. Yeah, that's lovely.
So
that's
is that all right?
Perfect.
Got to wait for Anne to, because she's bought her knitting in, because she don't join her wool on, and joins it on.
Joins it on, right.
Yeah, so we've got to wait for Anne to do that, and Anne's trying to do a shopping list as well.
Okay, lovely. No, that's great. That's really great. Rose is going great, guns, yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, really good.
So you like my baby's doing?
Oh, yeah.
The baby's there over there, on the special chair.
Oh,
yes.
Right.
Yes.
We get Michael to take a photograph, is that?
Yes. Yeah, they look nice on there.
Mm.
Well, put them up on your board.
Yeah.
Yeah, put them up on my board. Oh, and you, one of you with your jumper on.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, good.
Well, that's why I thought, now what one should I wear? And I thought, no, I'll wear this one because it's got the short sleeves. Mm. I thought, don't want to wear me big roller neck heavy jumper. This
I like the neck on that one.
I thought it was a bit warm out, but when I got outside,
it's cold.
Living cold, I know.
I got my shoes out, and when I went out the garden with the dog, I put my boots on. I thought, no, I'm not going out in shoes.
I still suppose you've got them on to kick Michael, keep him under control.
You know, I do. I don't tell you that. I have to kick him, especially in the shins.
Oh.
I'm the only one they can ever laugh with.
You've got a really good sense of humour.
Yes.
Yes. Ah,
yes. Oh, my friend Robbie torments life out me indoors sometimes. Even when we talk on the phone, he makes me laugh. But it's funny, my husband was a tourist abroad, and so is he. And they got nearly the same birthdays.
No.
My husband was the 11th of May, and my friend is the 9th of May.
Oh. Yes. When's your birthday, Rose?
30th of September.
Ah.
I'm a Libra.
Yeah. Yeah.
Scales.
Yeah, so is my son, the little one. Yeah. Yeah.
Is he a proper Libra?
Tell me about Libra.
Well, they've got lots of patience. They're artistic, make things, they're clever at making things.
Yeah.
Make friends easily.
Yeah, he does do that, yes.
Yes.
Yes, yeah.
Always smiling.
Yes.
And when you're happy, unhappy, you go and sit on your own. You don't go and talk to anybody.
All right, so you deal with it on your own?
Yes.
Mm. Yes. Well, that's a good thing to do, isn't it? Yeah.
Go and cry by yourself.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I had a lovely husband.
What was his name?
Fred.
Fred.
If he was naughty, his mum would say, Frederick! He used to make me laugh. I was married 35 years.
Were you, Rose? Mm. Yeah.
He'd have gone to the doctors when I kept asking him to. He wouldn't have died. Because they'd have given him tablets. Because he kept tripping over and he said he'd fallen over the pain, but he wasn't.
Oh.
It was a starting of little blood things and had a stroke, didn't he?
Oh.
I had him 7 years looking after him.
Looked after him, Rose?
Yes. The carers got him up in the mornings and I looked home after him the rest of the day.
Have a good feel, Rose. Have a good feel.
What's that?
You won't get here. Have a feel.
What?
Have a good feel of this.
Oh.
She is.
What are you doing?
I'm just stitching a blanket, Shana.
Oh, right.
Shana, what I can do, I want to buy a duvet cover for my single bed.
Yeah.
I've got a big double bed, but I've got plenty of them, but I want a nice, because my little great niece are never getting a bit bigger now.
Yes.
And they want to come and...
Come and stay?
Yeah, they want to come, that's gone a bit thick there.
It looks all right, though. It's nice, it's got a nice weight to it, which is great, because that's the edge, Rose, so it needs to have that there, doesn't it? Thank you. You're just, obviously just doing...
It's a lot, crikey, it's a lot to do.
Yeah, don't worry.
They'll take me 6 months. I won't do any other handicrafts.
No, I'll make sure there's a lot of variety. But I'm just interested at the moment in...
What I'm doing.
In what you're doing and how you do it all by, obviously by touch. But the way that you do it, I'm very interested in the process.
When my nieces say what I get up to and their friends don't believe them, and they say, she cooks, she does her own dinners.
Well, this is what my husband didn't believe last week, yeah. I said, she irons, she cooks cakes, bakes cakes.
All your own housework.
Have you got a favourite cake that you bake?
Yes, cherry and banana.
Oh, I bet that's good. That's hang on a minute.
That's 1, 5... 4 and 5, that's D. 5 and 1, 2, 3. So I've got up doing a dot, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1 and 6 is E.
Oh, right. Got
you
it.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
So you've got little dots, 6 for, it's got, they're called cells. Six. And it's on a frame and there's 6 little loops in each thing.
Along. Rose, how do you keep in a straight line then when you're reading
Braille? Oh, so the Braille is in the, when you write it, it's in the, on a frame.
Right, so that keeps metal.
And you've got what they call the stripes, like a sewing needle with a little wooden top.
Yeah.
And you prick out the words, dots.
Yeah, I've not ever thought about this at all.
And then you've got 1, 4 and 5 is D. E is a 1, 2, 3. See, I'm trying. I can read the braille, but I'm trying to think. Yeah,
it's difficult without it, I guess.
No, the frame, yeah.
Because can you read
braille? Yes.
No, when you try to read something, and not, I mean, write something, Rose. Are you able to? Because
write my name and address and things like that. Yes, but I can't. And I've got a frame indoors.
Yeah.
And it's got elastic across. So you hold the elastic and then you just write like you would normal.
Yes, I've got one of those, but I can't read my writing back.
No, that's me. I can't read it back.
No.
So you've got to know, you've got to spell it, and you've got to know. And what I do, when I do the word, then I put my finger and write the other side till it spaces out even.
Yeah.
So you don't have it too close, because you write to go, it all runs in one and there's no spaces to put your stops and commas and things, is there?
No. That's so difficult, Rose.
So you've got to space it out. Mm. But if you don't keep doing it, you do lose the
heart.
This
is right. It's like everything, isn't it? If you don't keep practising, you lose it, which is...
As a lady in the bank said, as long as you can write your name and address, Rosie, where you live, and how much you want to have to pay the money back.
That's important, to keep a track on where the money
goes.
Till May.
Mm-hmm.
And... I'd like to see how it can carry on. So the idea is that I find ways of people knowing what you're doing and getting it to carry on, so getting some craft to carry on, and helping Anne really see what's possible.
Mm.
But the thing is, I could carry on coming as well, so it's not, it definitely won't be a stop, it'll just be that at the moment I'm gathering the information and finding out what suits and what's a good idea, yeah? And then...
Well, different blind people do different...
Yes, and so that takes quite a bit of time.
A lot of people say, I can't do it and I don't want to do it and...
And so it takes quite a bit of time to figure out what different people like to do, how long they like to do it. Because, like, obviously, Rose, you're happy sat there. You've been sat there for some time now. Somebody else might not have a longer concentration span. So it's very particular.
Oh, yeah, but some people give up easy, don't they?
Yes, there is that as well, yes. That's lovely, Patsy.
Well, look at these blankets.
That was the idea, Patsy, that it was fabric that was soft and domestic and that something that people were used to that I used.
How did you find something like this, though, this lovely colours?
Well, when they said go ahead with the project, I went scurrying around looking.
Because I haven't seen Blank World, and not that I'm getting get out that much to look around, but all you seem to see is the fleecy blankets these days, isn't it?
Yes, with
not
the sin-
this lovely
yes.
Sort of warm field.
Yeah, but you go in charity shops.
Would you find some, didn't
you? Oh, yeah, I bought lovely blankets like this, and I've cut them up smaller for my guide dog's beds.
It's you've got to be on the lookout, haven't you? Because otherwise, the synthetic ones, they're sold in the market stalls, aren't they?
Yeah, yes.
But
these proper blankets, you often when people clear out, not being rude, but elderly people die.
Yeah.
And they have blankets, and their children take all the stuff to the charity
yeah,
shop.
Yes. They really want to know, Rosie, do they?
It That one that you're working on there, Patsy, it's got a couple of moth holes there.
Is it?
Yeah.
That's lovely, isn't it?
I mean, obviously I cut into it, but I did come across it, and really, if you bring something like that into your house, you could bring the moth in as well, couldn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
Do give it a good spray or wash it.
Well, I just went along with it.
Oh, I see.
I didn't tell my husband. There was a hole in that.
If you close the shape before you go on, Pat. She's warned you, don't know moths in yet.
No moth flew out,
no
so.
Moth, no moth.
I thought Madge was going to stop in here.
No, what? No.
Oh, I don't know why she came in, really.
Is that another lady, Rose?
It's over the corner.
Oh, yeah.
You know the man who fetches money for the bingo?
Oh, yes.
His wife.
Oh, his wife, yes. Oh,
no. Patsy, did you used to do a lot of embroidery then?
Yes, I did. Yeah, with, Lazy Daisy and patchwork and, or anything. Because I wasn't...
That'd be nice to make. All the little squares make a patchwork and throw over.
Yeah.
Yeah, she says.
There's some
giving her ideas.
Yeah.
I'll see her giving that look at me.
Rose, I'm smiling at you.
Yes, it's so lovely. The thought of being able to sit and do something like that when you can't is...
Well, I'm glad my mum kept me knitting.
Yeah.
Because if I didn't... Well, you know Maureen who does the lunches?
Yeah,
but
I do.
Well, I knitted her a waistcoat.
Lovely.
And then Gwyneth, I knitted her a red one.
How do you manage with the pattern then, Rose? How do you manage that? Because the decreasing and increasing and you forget where you are.
Well, it's only when you get the arm old shape, it's only four off, and knit right across and come back and cut four off. That's your shaping, isn't it?
Yeah. And your phone, Anne.
When you remember where you've got to and you put it down.
Well, you measure, with your tape measure.
And you phone Anne in the evening, don't you?
And I give Anne a phone. And then she got her pattern, she says, you got a knit, how big is it? So I said, I'll leave that bit and start on the other bit. Then I leave that knit.
Oh, God, dear.
You've got another inch to do, all right. She said, go and do that, and I do that, and then...
I should be, I don't know.
Oh, sometimes I ring up three or four nights a week, getting all the bits and measurements.
That is dedication, Rose.
And
dedication for a man as well.
Yeah, she's good.
Maureen out there, I knitted this waistcoat and put pockets in it. I've got half of one out there now for her daughter. I've done the two fronts. I'm halfway up the back and do the sleeves. And she said, would you knit her a cardigan? I said, yes, I said. I just finished my own card. I do that. No, Gwyneth's pink one, red one. So she's black. No, I said I can't knit black.
No, that is not nice. But so many shops now selling wool. So many of the charity shops are selling wool, aren't they now?
But they've always had.
Have they? Well, I've not
noticed. Oh, God, I've bought wool in there loads of times. I made up, knitted a two-coloured jumper or done it with three colours.
Thank you.
See you.
Just say if you want some help. I might go and see if Rosie wants to come back. Are you two okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Oh, great.
Your concentration.
Do you do much sewing at home, Rose?
Well, I've been doing a tapestry.
Oh, golly heaven, that's wonderful.
But I'm not very pleased with it because I know it isn't as good as what I have done before. Yeah.
But when your eyes aren't working, you know, you're not able to see quite so well, that's an undertaking even to have done that, I reckon.
It's not as neat at the back of the work as I've done before, if you know what I mean. It looks passable from the front to follow
thing.
The pattern, yeah. But not as good as I know I could have done.
Started yet by the sound of it,
right? There's a lot of noise going on at the
moment. Going on, isn't there? We haven't had to pay any more to the holiday, Rose, have we?
No, not as far as I know.
I haven't heard anything. I'm going to come until about May, June time.
Oh, yeah. Right.
If you would like to sit there, Brenda.
Okay, thank you.
There, okay, and we'll have a chat.
Yeah.
Do you know...
Hello, Brenda.
Hello.
Hello, Brenda.
Hello.
On the bus. Oh, so there's Patsy and Rose.
All right.
Patsy's... was here with me last week,
mm-hmm.
And Rose is having a go now. Yeah. Mm. So, if I start by just telling you a little bit about what I'm doing,
yeah,
and then maybe you could tell me a little bit about how much you can see, so that I can help you and see what suits. Yeah. Basically, my job. I'm a teacher at college and teach 18-year-olds fashion and textiles. And I'm also an artist, and when I'm an artist I like to do projects with people,
mm-hmm.
And the Arts Council have funded me to come in and do some textiles with people in this group, and
you've run out of cotton
so I'll keep talking, yeah, and I'll find us some more cotton. That's brilliant, Rose, that's great. If I finish you off, oh, that is tidy. That's lovely. And so I'm coming every Tuesday, Brenda, to work with people on these big blankets, where we're doing different stitches, different applique, a bit of weaving, whatever suits people.
Mm-hmm.
And people can... people can have a little rest and have a go. Actually, is Anne saying something important?
No, she's announcing what's going on throughout the year.
Oh.
But she's got it all typed up and printed, so we get a copy of it anyway.
Okay. So. All right, okay. So, and there's a hot meal in the hall, and it will cost you £6.
She's selling it.
Have you been to that before?
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Can you come in?
If it's good weather, it's in Anne's garden, and she does lots of cakes and strawberries and cream, and there's usually
sounds nice
some alcohol there if people want it.
Oh.
So you are Pat.
I'm Rose.
You're Rose.
I'm Rose. I'm Big Rose.
You're Big Rose, right? Okay.
Yes, it's a lot of hot meals.
And it's if it's in here, then you have like the same things, cake and strawberries.
Going all the way to Christmas.
Stuff. And we couldn't come back here, could we, last year?
No.
No.
We went to
United before.
That's right.
You're glad to get home when you've been that cold, aren't you, actually?
Miserable. Yes. Well, we had a nice tea, didn't we?
Oh, we did. Lots of sandwiches and cakes and sausage rolls and cheese and pineapple.
Oh,
lovely, lovely.
Is that yours?
And I sat opposite to that nice old boy that...
Oh, bless you, thank you.
Wrote the poem. I'll
set you up with
Ernie. Yeah.
I sat opposite him, which was quite nice. Oh, we're missing out then.
Are you going on holiday?
Yes.
Are you going on holiday, Patsy? Is it Patsy?
I am.
Yeah. She and I are sharing a room.
Great.
Oh, so you're getting educated this year then?
Yes. Brenda, are you going on holiday?
I am indeed.
Oh, excellent.
Oh, you're going as well, are you?
I am.
Oh, that's nice.
Good.
This is my fourth one.
Oh, gosh.
And when I first went, I was like apprehensive. I thought, oh, I've not done, been away with the group for ages.
No, neither have I.
Yeah, apprehensive.
Neither have I come to that. Been family, but not.
But you do become very educated on holiday.
Oh, do we?
Yes.
I'm not too sure. I'm not. I like what the way you're saying that.
It's all good fun, all good sense of humour.
Oh,
we all have a laugh.
So, the idea is that people have a go, and there's no wrong way or right way of doing it. And it's not the outcome that's important; it's the process, it's the experience. So when we sew, and we engross ourselves in a craft activity like this, we lose ourselves. We lose a sense of time, and it's good for our brain, and it's enjoyable. And it passes the time. So that was the plan for me coming, okay? And I've been very lucky to find the group and be funded by the Arts Council. And the group have responded really well.
Good.
Now, there's a variety of things that people have been trying in the group. And so if I just show you this here, and just wonder from you what you can see here, what colours you can see, and how it feels to you. What's
The colours are pretty rubbish. I can't see the colours very well.
No, so the colour's not a good thing for you.
No.
No, okay.
And that's a sparkly bit, but I can't tell you what it is.
Okay.
I'm totally blind in the right eye.
Yes.
And I've got very blurred vision in the left with a cataract coming.
Oh, right. Yeah.
But they say a lot of it is unexplained nerve damage.
Oh, okay. So will you be able to have the cataract worked on then?
Once it has to be done when it's a certain stage, because if they do it too soon, it has to be done again.
Okay,
right. But the stupid thing is, they tell you that the stage is till you nearly can't see.
Right, so it's chicken and egg, really, isn't it?
It is. Difficult. Yeah.
Yes.
They say, well, you can't do it until it's ready to be done, and in your case, it won't get done until you nearly can't see.
Okay.
Right. Great, thank you very much.
Right, okay.
Can't see in one eye already, so, you know, got to wait for the other one to...
Yes. Can you feel the... Brenda, can you feel these holes? If I take your hand, there's some holes here with some threading. Can you feel that?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Because one of the things that I've been doing is we've got some blanket over there with some big holes, a grid with big holes in it, and we've been threading... big pieces of cord through it. Would you be able to do something like that?
I mean, years back, well, I suppose it seems years because I can't do it anymore. I used to do card making.
Oh, yes.
And I've got a whole box of card punches indoors.
Yeah.
All different shapes. And I used to sit there for hours and make Christmas. One card could take me an hour and a half.
It's quite fiddly as well, that, isn't it?
And I used to, like you say with this, I used to get totally absorbed in it and the time would just go.
Yes.
And I'd sit there quite happily doing all the cards and everything. And way before that I did tapestry with, it had to be a long stitch tapestry.
Yes.
So that when you went in one hole you were doing a stitch of about three or four
squares. Yes,
long.
Covering
three. So I used to do that, but as I say, I haven't done my cards for ages.
Okay.
I mean, now I haven't got a table to... I used to sit... My kitchen has got a roof window. So I used to pull the table out that I had, pull the leaf up and just sit there. I could have all my mess around me. But I got rid of the table and I haven't done it for a long time.
Yeah.
So I don't know whether I mean, I probably could do it. It would take me a lot more concentration now.
Yeah. So if I set you up round there to do some threading for me and some weaving, that might work quite well, yeah?
Yeah, whatever.
Okay. That's lovely.
Certainly is a long sausage blanket.
Right, and then you have a bit to see, measure to see how long I've got.
You get it out while I'm getting the patterns for you. You right, Rose Pose?
Yes. I'm getting on with me jumper.
Are you?
She busy knitting on there.
What are you going to start?
I'm weaving a blanket through some holes.
Ooh.
Ooh, get me, eh?
I'm on to sewing.
Ooh, get you, eh?
Yes.
What are you going to sew?
I'm doing my edge of a blanket and on the clap.
Yes, it's here. Yeah, it's here.
I've just had a look at it, Rose. You've done very well, haven't you?
Yes. Hopefully.
Who are you making it for, Rose?
I'm not making it for anybody, it belongs to Nicola.
Oh, bless
you. And she said, can you do this outfit stitch thing?
What are you knitting now, Rose?
Pardon?
What are you knitting?
My cardigan.
Oh, you're knitting cardigan?
No, not mine.
No.
No more in that comes home with the lunches.
I'm doing my blanket stitch, which is quite lovely. Well, it's quite lovely.
What's
about
this
quite
bit
lovely,
I've got here?
It's a lovely thing to do, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, good. You all right, Brenda? Yeah, I'm weaving a bit of blanket.
Oh, right. Oh, I see.
There's more holes there, right?
There will be a special way to do it.
I was waiting to learn something.
I tell you what, by next week I'll ask my technician at work and she'll show me the proper way.
She's got a certain amount of funding.
If it works and it looks half decent, that I'm fine with that.
There's a bit in there.
I thought I won't finish it off.
And if you can make it,
I'll watch them how she
finishes
it.
I sort of weave it.
So if you should finish that,
and it stays secure and it looks decent. So. You've got a little burn on your hand, haven't you?
On my finger, yeah.
Did you burn it?
Well, I cooked me dinner and I put my plate. I got one of those grills. I didn't have it alight, but it gets warm from the oven at the bottom. And I pulled the front down and put my plate in to warm up.
Yeah.
But as I got my plate out...
She just nipped to the bank because she needs some money. And obviously she can't go this afternoon because we've got nobody to go with them because of it's the AGM.
Yes.
So,
yeah.
But she wants to come out here when she comes back from the bank.
All that's right. Great. Thank you. So what happened?
Of course, being the... Just forming a plate, it wouldn't be hot. Because I lift a plate up, I didn't have my oven gloves on, and I pulled it up, because the top of the bar hit the top of my finger. So I run it under cold water, and then I started rubbing germaline on it, so it doesn't hurt hardly anymore.
Does it hurt now?
No.
Do you have lavender oil? That hurt helps sometimes, doesn't it?
Well, I've got lavender oil, but I don't.
That's meant to help.
Oh, is it?
Mm. You have to put it on straight away.
Yeah. Well, I know they say run it under cold water when you burn yourself.
Yeah. They used to say put butter on it, didn't it?
No, carbonated soda.
Oh, you know, that's for everything, isn't it?
Yes.
That's brilliant stuff, isn't it?
All I did was run my hands under cold water and I just got the carbonate out of the pot and I just smarmed it all over. That's why I never got a blister, wasn't it?
Yes. Yeah, it's a little bit sore looking now, yeah.
Yeah, but it doesn't hurt now.
No. Have you been on the computer at the weekend?
No.
No? So just listening to the radio?
I've got a computer, but I had 6 weeks' lessons and, we're coming out, but nobody ever turned up anymore after that. So my computer's sitting on the side, not doing anything.
Gathering dust?
No, I'll keep it clean. I go and do all my housework when I've got nothing to do.
Well, it must be as clean as a pin then, since Thursday.
Over all through Sunday.
Yeah.
I cleaned all my shower room out, washed all... I got on my hands and knees and I scrubbed all my shower floor. I got a big shower, big walk-in.
Have you?
Yeah, big... quite a big room.
That's
as you go in, I got a big sink there,
yeah.
Toilet opposite, then from there, right up, is what? 12 foot long, about 6 foot wide.
Yeah.
Well, it used to be for a wheelchair person.
Oh, brilliant. So you've got a lot of space going on there.
Yeah, well, my husband went had a stroke, didn't he?
Yeah.
And everybody said, he left going home, you can't look after him. I said to him, what do you want to do? Do you want to go in a home? I'm married to you, he said, I want to go home.
Yeah.
He could talk and feed himself, it's just that it affected his legs. And he couldn't walk. So I had to have carers come get him out of bed and dress him and put him in a wheelchair. Oh, he built himself an electric wheelchair car. We used to walk miles. He'd say to the ladies, put me in my wheelchair, we're going out today. And I'd walk along the side with my guide dog and he'd press the button on his wheelchair and off we used to go. Used to laugh when we slowed up shopping though. Good job had a big bag on the back. He said, come, let's go and do the shopping.
Too much shopping. Yeah, well, it's like having a pushchair, isn't it? You buy too much and then you've got to load it up.
Well, I had a big bag on the back, electric wheelchair, and that took the weight.
You looking forward to your holiday?
Yes. Well, I'm having 2 holidays.
Oh, right.
I'm having one, well, about 3 weeks' time, I think. First weekend in June. First Sunday in June we go.
Yeah.
For a week. And then I'm going with the Maystone Club and I'm going to Isle of Wight for a week.
Oh, right, yeah.
Well, I normally have 2 weeks, but these are just where I've... Well, the other year before last, I had a week with the club and I had 2 weeks in Egypt. Not going abroad this year, so I'm having 2 weeks.
Yeah.
One with this club and one with the Maystone Club.
Yeah.
But the Maystone one, we're going Isle of Wight.
Hmm. On the coach?
Oh, yeah, it takes us on a coach.
Yeah.
And they give you your labels for your tattoo cases. funny, I only said to Brenda just now, I said, "Cool, we ain't got many weeks." He said, "Yeah, we better start packing." Right? He said, "Yeah, we better head." Funny, I was sorting out my sandals yesterday.
Oh, well, there you are. Yeah, you're getting ready then.
I've chucked them in the case, but I haven't got them packed, really.
Rose, can I just help with that piece of thread? Because I think it's coming to its... I'll lengthen it for you.
Oh, yes, it's getting... It's
getting double low out.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. I'll just remove the knot a bit. And if I just take that little bit from you and just loosen the knot a bit, and then you've got more to play with, yeah? Hang on, I'm not that fast. Okay. This is bright yellow that you're doing, daffodil yellow.
Oh, and what colour's the blanket?
Well, the blanket is...
It's blanket colour, brown.
No, brown. No, it's peach.
Oh, peach.
Yes. Oh. So, it's one of my favourite colours, actually. Have you got a favourite colour, then? That's not a trick question.
No, blue and lavender.
Blue and lavender.
Lavender was my mum's favourite colour.
I love lavender, though. It's lovely, isn't it?
My dad's favourite colour was cerise.
Oh.
And once I can remember, mum made us dresses. And they were little sweet aunt neck short sleeves, and just a straight body, isn't it? Big, wide, pleated skirt. But not little pleated, big, wide box pleats.
Yeah.
Like, if she'd got the material and folded like that and it sewed in onto a waistband.
Mm-hmm.
And it's big, wide pleats all round. But had a little belt from the side round the back. And they were cerise. And everybody said, "Oh, your dress is lovely." Because she said, "Oh, Mum, my mum made them." Nah, she never. Yes, she didn't. And you get in an argument.
Did she have a sewing machine or was it by hand?
Some sewing machine and some she did by hand.
Yeah, yeah.
Tricky bit, she did by hand.
Yeah.
And if she made us petticoats, the old sheet, she'd make us cotton or nighties.
Mm.
And then she used to embroider little flowers around the neck and round the bottom. And we all had different flowers, so we didn't argue over the nighties.
Oh.
Being five girls.
Yeah.
But the eldest daughter, she was married, but the other, there was only, 5 years between four of us. Because there was me, 2 years later was Daphne, and then she was three, and my mum had twins.
Mm.
I had twin brothers and twin sisters.
Oh, she had her arms full, didn't she? I bet she never sat down, did she?
Oh, she did.
Did she? Well, to make the dress into the night.
Yeah, well, my big brothers was good to her.
Yeah.
And my Albert was a brilliant brother, yeah, and Richard. Our two big brothers, sister, then a brother. Then she went quite a long time, had me, and then she had Daphne, and then she
on the pedals.
There was a very cheap way of moving a bit of plastic to move her forward. It still needs a cushion, really. So I had to go very slowly, and she had to go very quick to keep it straight.
Sorry. And I'm pedalling like that.
Did you manage that?
And I made him laugh. I said, "Christ, the ducks are going fast."
two ducks swam by us. We've got a bit of wood jammed under the propellers.
They're not got smashed up with a willow
tree. So in the end, she sacked me.
Did she sack you?
Captain Pug was the cabin boy.
Yeah. Oh, but we did have a laugh, didn't we?
Well, everybody else thought it was funny. We were trying to go by.
Yeah.
I
don't mind. Whatever.
But I couldn't find the pedals. My legs
couldn't
were
reach it.
Oh, well, you couldn't reach
Lydia,
it.
Lydia, and I wiggled to the end, and I eventually got my feet on. But he was already pedalling away, and we were going round.
We got there and back in the end.
We had
two ducks overtook us.
Yeah, we did.
It was good fun, wasn't it, Paul?
It was good fun, and it was nearly a year ago. That's the worrying bit, right?
Are you going to take her out again? That's the thing.
We're going out of speedboat this time.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
We're going out of speedboat. Yeah. Either that or a yacht, and then she won't see the old boom.
I was
going
to say, I'm a bit worried about that. She might not.
I'll tell you what we could do, like Wallace and Gromit, an old sidecar, motorcar, mountain boat and sidecar.
Yeah.
You have to lean over when we go one way round.
Yeah, no.
Keep the wheel on the ground.
Well, my brothers had motorbikes, didn't they?
Yeah, that was a day. Noisy things.
They were.
Right. I'll leave you to your endeavours.
Oh, we did have love, if you're not already, no.
It's good, isn't it, Rose? Good, yeah. Good to laugh.
It really is, Mr. Pope.
Yeah.
But I don't.
Nice to behave like a kid again.
What my dad said, they said, "Where did you watch telly a lot?" I said, "No." Well, how do you know a bit about Mr. Pugwash? I said, "I don't know. Just sort of walk around collecting." I said, "It's a toy children's program, what is it?"
That's years ago too, Captain Pugwash. My children had to watch Captain Pugwash.
Yeah. The music was very memorable, wasn't it?
Oh, well, was it just?
I never knew, did I? I'll just call
you.
And when they told me, we was, oh, we did laugh. Especially when I couldn't feel the paddles. he's peddling away leisurely. I said, "Why are we going round and round, boys?" He said, "Because you're not working."
He must have known, though, before you, he must have looked at that boat and thought, those paddles are pedals are a long way from Rose's legs, feet. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he knew that, didn't he?
Yeah,
but he just had to laugh.
He wanted to
go through his spectacle.
He wanted a reaction, didn't he?
Yeah.
And of course, I wriggled to the end of the sea, and he slowed up a bit. Once I got my feet on the bit, we was well away.
Yeah.
And he shouted out to Wayne, "I wish you had a cushion." And we had a good old laugh on the boat round and.
Okay, I've come to a different size of. Didn't this one go as far as,
or what?
Yeah.
Shall I carry on or
yes,
what?
Yes, if you can.
What through the smaller?
Yes.
Okay.
If you can, if it's not too difficult. Yeah.
I'm worried about pulling your.
Oh, don't worry about pulling because I can.
You know the ribbons out.
Straighten it all out, and I'm going to make it into a shape similar that you just tried on.
All right.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, so pretty and lovely and warm.
What are you doing, Rosie?
Well, I'm weaving, actually.
Oh, are you?
Yeah. Mm. I'm making a kibosh.
Do you think you are?
Well, I'm trying to get this to match the other end, and it's not going to, no matter what I do.
Don't worry about it, though.
Somebody else has done a different thing at the other end, then?
Yeah, yeah.
Was that your wife? Your wife be the same. Will it, Rose?
I get blamed at my house all the time for everything.
Well, Mum's allowed to take the blame anyway.
Yeah, it's easier.
Easy for Mum to take the blame. I never done it, Mum. It was Dad.
You see, that doesn't tally with that.
Well, as I said to Rose this morning when she first came in, I said it doesn't actually matter what it looks like too much. It's the fact that you took part and you had a go that's more important. Because Rose was saying, "Well, what colour is it?" And she said, "I can't see it." And I said, "Yeah, it doesn't matter what it looks like. It's the fact that, you know."
Yeah, I'm having a go.
Having a go, keeping busy, keeping hands busy. Yeah, getting involved.
Oh, my, they're always busy.
Yeah.
They're always busy.
I know. It's a sign of
that song, "Busy Doing Nothing," sing that all day through. Finding lots of things not to do. Finding things not to do.
I do a lot of embroidery, you know, so.
Sing it, don't they?
I suppose that's still supple.
Well, when
good.
It's not that's a problem, it's the other end that's the bloody problem. Excuse my language. Legs. I've had to lift my husband so much that my joints are wore out, you know. That's all there is to it, basically. Because he was... he played cricket, and he had a cricket ball hit him between the eyes with such a force that it rocked his brain, and it caused the epilepsy.
Oh.
And I found that hard to live with. But then one night he got up, and I went into a dead sleep for a change, and I didn't hear him. Next thing I know, there's a gigantic bang downstairs, and I thought somebody was breaking in, but it wasn't that. It was John. He'd had a massive stroke, as well as a huge epileptic fit at the same time. And he became disabled from that day on. So,
well, that's what happened to my husband. Collapsed in the street, and he had a stroke.
No, John was indoors,
I looked after him for 7 years, and my sister said to the hospital, "She'll have to put him away." They said if she has carers at home, she's quite capable. And I looked after him for 7 years. And I used to lift him forward, take his shirts and tops off. And if he couldn't get up and walk anywhere, and he said, Rose, I want to go loo. I said, don't worry, you're padded up. And I said, roll him about. And I said, clean him up, change him, everything. And the carers used to be amazed when they come in. You should have waited. I said, I couldn't leave him like that. And you don't come till 2 o'clock. Sometimes you both come at 12 o'clock.
Rose, did you have the community nurses then?
Excuse me, can I ask Rose Harvey a question?
Rose,
you didn't have any Christy. Do you want Christy?
You've been having
Christy,
you darling? No, I didn't want any today.
Oh,
that's
all
right. No.
Maureen
did ask me, love.
Yeah, that's all right. Only sometimes she forgets.
Yeah, sometimes I do have them, yeah.
Yeah, and sometimes she leaves them off and leaves
them. Right. I don't have them for a little while, and then I go back on them. Thanks, Doreen.
Did you want to go the other way now, or what?
Yes, if you... Yes. Your game. Yes.
That way, I mean.
Yes.
Shall I manoeuvre
it?
Look, they're all
that yeah, look,
that's all right, though.
Other two
like
flat.
Myself. I'll tack it. Like myself, Rose. Peter was ill for 6 years.
Yeah. But people said, oh, don't put me in our way. He said, don't put me in our way. I said, I won't. Well, he wouldn't put me in our way.
No, this is exactly
not many squares that way, are there?
This lovely sun through this window. It's a better day than I thought it was going to rain today.
Anyway, I had to look after my husband for 14 years.
Road Marvel's for 7.
And of course it's wore all my joints out.
Yeah.
The week before that,
it's just finding something different than an attempt to archetype, isn't it, really?
Yes.
You know, not having the same thing week in and week out.
That's right.
You know, you can do online shopping with, like, Tesco's and home delivery.
Yeah, but you've got to have a computer, haven't you?
Yeah, but does the Blind Association not have a system?
No.
Because that would be really helpful, wouldn't it?
The only thing that helps you is people like Anne. Up the Kent Association don't want to know, love.
Or
they're not interested.
Or another question then, Rose, would Tesco's be able to help you, say, have a, you know, like, when you do your online shopping, you just tick the same boxes, I want cheese, I want milk, yes? There should be a way of helping people who can't
see. I think I might try and find out if I could get the phone number and ring it up.
Yes.
I don't know.
Oh, so do
I know
it on
they
the
do
phone?
It online, but I haven't got. I've
Rose,
got.
Rose, you've got the BT number, haven't you?
Yes.
The number you can ring. BT.
Yes.
195.
Yes.
Yeah. Good. Oh, that's good. Well, I find that very helpful.
Okay. Yeah. Do you want?
Well, I could ring them and say, "Could you put me through to Tesco's through, please?" And they would.
Yeah.
And I'd say, "Could you help? I'm a blind person. I can't get to the shop." Because I've got my guide dog anymore. See, that was helpful.
Yeah.
I could go up and do a little... I could go for a walk every day and go carry
Rose,
just enough.
What's happened about your dog then?
They retired her.
But she's with... Oh, not got to another one. I know they're very expensive to train.
Not yet.
But Tesco's then could deliver, couldn't they, Rose?
That's what I'm saying. If I could... I might do that. Good directories, give me Tesco's... Strood's number and ring up and ask help, you know.
Yeah.
But then you might have to have a certain amount, mightn't you? Like, have to spend so much before they deliver.
I see what you mean. Oh, yeah, a definite
figure, like £25 or for £30 or. And living on your own, you don't need all that, really.
No, I but they might be. They might be able to make special concessions. Well, the little vans are going around all the time, aren't they, Rose? That's all I was thinking.
I don't know.
But the thing is, something like computer technology should be able to help you more, shouldn't it? Do you have a computer, Patsy?
I've got a laptop, but I can't do anything about it at the moment because I can't see to use it. And I'm supposed to be hearing from the KAB about a course.
They only give you 6 weeks, love. That's all they give me.
Did they?
Yes. They only give you 6 weeks. Every week for 6 weeks. And then you don't, you got to get on yourself then. And then the next
They give you the basics.
They just give you the basics. Yes. I don't really get you into computer. Yeah. No.
I feel really worried because everything is moving, is it, into electronic.
Yeah. Well, that's right, and we're getting left behind.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
But it should actually be the opposite way, shouldn't it? It should be the technology is making your, you know, particular
our lives easier.
Yes, it isn't. Absolutely.
No, it's making it more difficult, isn't it, Pat?
It is. It
really.
Is. I mean, obviously, that's partly because of the speed of change. Is that it's more difficult.
I never thought of that, Pat. Yeah. Bringing up directory inquiries, get the
number.
Get either that or Sainsbury's. But Tesco's and Morrison's being the nearest shop.
They would
be the best ones, wouldn't they? Same as going in one of our big shops.
No, you need to.
Because in the big shop, like Sainsbury's or that, they do. Now, I know for a fact, in Morrison's, get up there, they do a cold meat called Astley.
Oh, that, yeah, Astley.
And that's
really
nice. But that's the only shop that does it. The other big, like Sainsbury's.
No,
they don't do it. Only Morrison's do it. Because it's a northern thing, isn't it?
I think it is, Rose. I don't know much about it.
Because Morrison's a northern shop.
Yes, that's very true.
Yeah. And they're the only ones that do it. I know, I've asked in the other shop. My friend Rob, he got me. But of course, he's waiting to have our operation now, so he mustn't drive. They've told him he mustn't drive now because he's going to have his operation on the 22nd of May. So he's got a cataract. So when he went up the hospital last week, they said, "Who brought you up?" He said, "I drove up." They said, "No, no, no, you shouldn't be driving."
No, 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 no. Where did this come from? I can't quite work out what I've done here.
Never mind.
I've got a piece hanging here, Nicola, and I've got a piece hanging here. And a piece hanging here.
And I've got a piece hanging here.
Where have I done? Where am I going?
There.
Where?
Right, now then. That is just the same piece.
Oh, that's the same.
That's the same one. That,
right.
Yes. And don't worry about this one. I'll sort this one out.
Okay, so where am I going with this? Oh, was that coming from the beginning then?
I believe I must
have. Well, no. Yes. How did I get
unraveled? Let me see if I can find a peg.
That's it.
It might have done.
I can't understand that.
Or I'll stitch it in for you straight away.
When you're finished, Nicola, could you give me three feather, please?
Of course I can. But that makes me think about mobile phones as well. Is that technology available to you as well?
Well, I've got a mobile phone, but I don't know how to use it.
Is it Braille?
No, it's not Braille.
I've got one with very, very big numbers on it.
Oh, you get phones with big numbers. Big squares. Not.
I haven't got anybody I can't text, so I don't carry it with me. So I haven't got anybody I can phone up. Well, I've got my family, but not to phone up in the daytime. So I don't have a phone. Well, I do, but I don't use it. Do you use yours, Rose? Rose number two?
No. No, I haven't got a mobile, and I got nothing electronic.
Yeah.
No modern electronic stuff at all.
I like that, Rose. You're just sitting there with your straw walls, aren't you?
Yes.
So you've got a gas cooker.
Good for you.
I got an electric cooker.
Yeah, but nothing
electronic. Yeah, I meant. For communication.
Oh, no, no, no.
Oh, does it?
Oh, I've only got an house phone.
You're so
I've got a mobile, but nobody told me how to really work it. The numbers are the same, but they're really small. So you could easily press two instead of one, if you know what I mean.
Now, my daughter used to nag me I ought to have a mobile phone when I used to drive. But I only finished driving last year.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't have one.
No.
Yeah. It was that your choice to stop driving then, Rose?
Yes.
Yes. Is it sort of a decision that sort of you come to?
No. After every treatment I had, I did always query, was I still eligible to drive?
Absolutely.
And I had been.
Yeah, yeah.
But when they said, we think you should get in touch with the KAB.
Yes.
The specialist said, the lady's already in the hospital today. Do you want me to give her a ring?
Yeah.
Well, as soon as he said that, I looked at my daughter and I said, well, I drove here. but I'm not driving myself home. I said, you're going to do it. So she said, oh, all right. I said, the car's yours. I gave her the keys straight away.
Yes.
So.
It's a big thing to give up. My husband hated it, absolutely hated giving up roads.
Pardon?
But my husband hated giving up driving.
So did I. Yeah,
although he couldn't drive, he just hated it. I suppose it's something to do with, well, just getting around, isn't it? You know, you're
well, still... lost independence, haven't
that's
you?
That's right, that's the right. Very word, Rose. Independence.
Lost independence.
And yeah. People enjoy it's driving with as dog, well, isn't
don't it? They? Not a guide dog, I can't go out when
do
I
do you prefer it that way? Or do you want me
do you
to
think you'll get another one, Rose?
Weave it?
I like it like that.
Well, they want me to have this long cane training.
Yes, I like it like that. Do you like it like that?
Is there a dog at the end?
I think it looks smooth. It doesn't look hobbled.
I'm quite able to walk about. I know where doors are. I know where stairs are. I know how to get to the bus stop. What do I want long cane training for? I didn't want to
try and stitch it on.
And you never forget it.
No, no.
So they're coming on the 29th of May.
It was too difficult to say.
So... don't know what's going to happen. But if they say no,
that's what bothers me.
Loads of my friends and family are not going to give guide dogs any money.
No, you don't quite.
No. Well, your nails go with it.
Could you buy it?
I'll have to tell her what you keep saying.
Oh, yes, there'd be a lot of money.
Well, you do. Well, you buy them in a roundabout way. Because you give money and you buy things like mugs and T-shirts and... I used to go out and do a lot of shaking, and I used to earn a load of money when I had my first guide dog. Thousands of pounds. I used to go to all the big shops, Yardley's, Marks & Spencer's, Pearl Insurance.
Did you like driving Rose?
Dog? You really
yes, I did. Yeah. I enjoyed it, but yeah. I will say this much.
Independence, Pat.
Yeah, you have to be very quick-witted today.
You have
to be up to it, don't you?
Yes.
Driving
under those circumstances, I was told I should register with the KAB. I thought I wasn't going to take the risk of having an accident and perhaps kill somebody. I'd never forgive myself. So, having been told that,
it's black and white, then, isn't it?
Then all my
you just get, you know, it is what it is, isn't it?
No, that's right. Blaming the club being shut up.
But yeah, even. You have to be quick witted, you can't be tired, you can't be anything.
That's the reason why.
Well, I'm sorry, I used to take a friend of mine out.
She's supposed to go with you.
With me sometimes. Well, quite often actually.
Well, at the moment,
she used to be stuck indoors like I was.
Oh, I didn't know that.
And I took her over to the farm where my daughter and son-in-law run their business from.
But I take her to the Thursday.
And that was way out in Collier Street near.
Yes, I know where Collier Street is, actually.
And my daughter got talking to her. She said, do you mind driving with my mother? So she said, I've never felt so safe in a car in all my life.
Oh, yeah.
So she said, I've got no worries about sitting with your mother while she's driving. So my daughter said, well, I know she's a good driver, but she said, I wondered how you felt about it. So she said, no, I'm fine. But it was only a few weeks later when they said I ought to register as with the KAB, and I thought, well, that's it.
Yeah,
you know, if anything happened, I've never caused an accident, and I didn't want to start then.
It's personal
because
confidence.
The first thing they would do is, as soon as they found out that I am registered with the KAB, they'd blame me, whether it was my fault or it wasn't.
Yeah.
I have got an awful memory these days. If my mind is taken off what I'm doing, that's it, it's gone.
Well, when you're up there, Franz could have said to you, she's gone down your friend, couldn't they?
Yeah, no, nobody said anything, so, you know, I thought, Rosie's not there. And, of course, you don't have something every week, do you?
No, no.
You only have it occasionally.
But don't worry, I'll go.
David's not here, because then, and then we go round Elsie's with her, don't we?
Yeah.
For that all. I've seen every note with them in the car.
Mm.
Ian pulls up and we pop out and
still looks a mess.
Yeah. But they're not they're on holiday.
Oh, I see.
Well, are you doing something different, Rose? What are you busy doing?
She's doing some mini.
Well, I come with their son.
Yeah. If it's something that you really need, that's
what are they like little wigwams? I was coming and looking at them.
So this is Patsy.
Afternoon for people.
And this is the blanket around Patsy.
And these
are going to go on a shelf in the exhibition as well.
Oh, how lovely. Yeah. Oh, so, let's come and have a look in a minute.
Yes, and well, you can do one of your own, Patsy.
Oh, I bet I can't. I couldn't see the detail.
Did you join this one together?
No, yeah.
If it could have lasted me till Thursday, then I could have got it when I went to Mesa.
Get it in Wilco's, because they sell milk, which isn't quite so far to go, is it?
I'll go.
You'll go, will you? Thank you.
I don't know Sitting Bourne, but someone...
Where do you live then, Nicola? Do you
Maidstone.
Oh, you're in Maidstone?
Yeah. And my sister lives in Sitting Bourne, but I don't go shopping in Sitting Bourne.
No, it's not the best.
Don't blame you.
No, it's not. I mean, it's all right.
Don't blame you, dear.
Patsy, do the blankets remind you of being little?
Yes, I think so.
Mm. And the weight of a blanket and sheets on your bed is... It's like you knew it was winter, you'd have like 3 or 4 sheet blankets.
That's right.
Oh, you did, didn't you? Did
and I can always remember my mum saving up, I mean, obviously we weren't particularly well off, for some Whitney blankets.
Yes.
And she sent away for 2 green ones, and I've still got one. I can't get rid of that.
Rose Dye.
Yes.